if f comma g belong to R of the closed interval a comma b. That is, the functions f and g are Riemann integrable over the closed interval a comma b, and the function g keeps the same sign throughout in the closed interval a comma b, then there exists a real number mu lying between the infimum and supremum of the function f, namely small m and capital M, such that integral from a to b f of x gx into dx is equals to mu into integral from a to b g of x into dx. This statement is known as first mean value theorem. We shall now prove the first mean value theorem. Proof: since f is Riemann integrable on the closed interval a comma b, it is bounded on the closed interval a comma b. Let small m and capital M be the infimum and supremum of the function respectively on the closed interval a comma b. Therefore, small m less than equal to f of x less than equal to capital M for all x belong to the closed interval a comma b. That is, the function f of x takes every value from small m to capital M. Since g keeps the same sign throughout the closed interval a comma b, we have two cases. The first case is g of x is greater than or equal to 0 for all x belong to the closed interval a comma b. That is, the function g of x is non-negative function. When g of x is non-negative, just now we have written small m less than or equal to f of x less than or equal to capital M for all x belong to the closed interval a comma b. We are going to multiply this inequality by g of x. Then we get m into g of x less than or equal to f of x into g of x less than or equal to capital M into g of x, because g of x is non-negative value. When you multiply this inequality, we have the same inequality here. There is no change in the inequality. Now, taking integral, so integral from a to b m into g of x into dx less than or equal to integral from a to b f of x gx into dx less than or equal to integral from a to b capital M g of x into dx.
This is the x-axis, this is the y-axis, this is the infimum small m, this is capital M stands for supremum. This curve stands for m into g of x, that is, the g of x is multiplied by the infimum, namely small m. This shaded region represents the area under the curve m into g of x. Therefore, this area is represented by integral from a to b small m into g of x into dx. This is the curve f of x into g of x. This region represents area under the curve f of x into g of x. Therefore, this area is represented by integral from a to b f of x gx into dx. This is the region under the curve capital M into g of x. Therefore, this area is represented by the integral from a to b M into g of x dx. Thus, we have three areas. One is area under the curve small m into gx. The second curve is under the curve f of x into g of x. The third one is capital M into g of x. So if we comparing all the three areas, we can write integral from a to b small m gx into dx, and this is the area. The second one is less than or equals to integral from a to b f of x gx into dx, that is the middle one. Less than or equals to integral from a to b capital M gx into dx, where g of x is greater than or equals to 0. This region is the area of the curve M into g of x, and the blue curve represent the function f of x into g of x. This region represented by the area under the curve f of x into g of x. We can also represent in another form. So this is the area under the curve M into g of x. This region represents the area under the curve f of x into g of x. This is the region which represents area under the curve capital M into g of x. So from this we can say that integral from a to b small m g of x dx is less than or equals to integral from a to b f of x g of x into dx, which is less than or equals to integral from a to b capital M g of x dx. Therefore, this capital M into g of x has more value than f of x g of x, which has more value than small m into g of x, and hence this inequality holds good.
Since small m and capital M are constant, we take them out. Therefore, m into integral from a to b g of x dx less than or equals to integral from a to b f of x g x dx less than or equal to capital M into integral from a to b g x into dx. Small m into integral from a to b gx dx less than or equal to integral from a to b f of x gx into dx less than or equal to m into integral from a to b gx into dx. Now dividing by integral from a to b gx dx, we know that gx is non-negative. When you divide, the inequality is preserved. Therefore, m less than or equals to integral from a to b f of x gx dx divided by a to b gx dx less than or equals to m. Now, let us take the value of integral from a to b f of x gx dx divided by integral from a to b gx dx as mu. If we take this value as mu, then M less than or equal to mu less than or equal to capital M.
Supremum of the function F in the interval A to B. So this is a value mu between small m and capital M. Therefore, mu belongs to close interval small m to capital M such that mu is equals to f of c, where c belongs to the close interval a comma b.
Now cross multiply, we get mu into integral from a to b gx dx is equal to integral from a to b f of x gx into dx. Therefore, mu belongs to the close interval small m to capital M such that integral from a to b f of x gx dx is equals to mu into integral from a to b gx dx. That is, the value of g of x is negative for all x belong to the closed interval a comma b. Just now we have proved the statement for g of x is greater than or equal to 0. Now we are going to prove the same statement for g of x is less than 0. Since m less than or equal to f of x less than or equal to capital M, for all x belongs to the closed interval a comma b, it is true for any function f of x. We are going to multiply this inequality with g of x whose value is less than 0. And we know that whenever we multiply an inequality by a negative value, the inequality will be reversed. Therefore, here when you multiply by g of x, we get m into g of x greater than or equals to f of x into g of x greater than or equals to m into g of x. G of x is less than 0. Taking integral, integral from a to b m into gx dx greater than or equals to integral from a to b f of x gx into dx greater than or equals to integral from a to b m into gx dx for all x belong to the closed interval a comma b. Since m is constant, take small m out. Integral from a to b g of x dx greater than or equal to integral from a to b f of x gx into dx greater than or equal to capital M into integral from a to b gx dx. As we discussed in case 1, therefore mu belongs to the closed interval M comma capital M such that integral from a to b f of x gx into dx is equals to mu into integral from a to b g of x into dx. Therefore, the statement is true for g of x greater than or equal to 0 and g of x less than 0. This completes the proof.